morning, y'all. This is your girl Sentinella, and I am back with another video. Okay, so as y'all can see, I am at home. This is my mama's house. I'm sitting in my truck right now. I already showed y'all what Big Ken looked like. So that means that I've made it from Tennessee. I told y'all back when I was in Jacksonville, Florida, from my previous video that I had to make a delivery and I go so many places. Shit, I think I went from Florida to Georgia. Right, then I went to Tennessee. And y'all, it's so many damn mountains, bro. It is so many goddamn mountains up there in Tennessee and in North Carolina. I went I-26. I didn't even know I-26 take you from South Carolina all the way up to, like, I want to say, like, you going to West Virginia. I didn't know I-26 went way up there. It cuts off once it turns into I-81. And I-81 is Virginia, West Virginia, Pennsylvania, like all of that. So I was like, wow, I did not know that. I did not know Asheville, North Carolina is like a mountain city. It kind of puts me in the mind of like one of them towns in upstate New York, how the houses and city downtown sit in mountains. Like, it's nice, but then nothing I could see myself living in. Like, and you can literally see like the mountains, the elevation, like when you driving through them, and how some parts of the mountains is snow, some parts is just dry. And I'm like, bro, that amazes me how climate can be so different like that. But that's enough on that on that. Me and my daddy just came back from Walmart. I got me some healthy stuff because, like I told y'all, that's that old vape. So I haven't vaped since January 1st done hit. So yeah, no more vaping. Didn't go to no vape store, even though I was tempted, but I didn't. And I got me some healthy stuff. I got me some salads and detox teas and water and all of that good stuff. But as I continue to vlog, I will be telling y'all some of the stuff I'm eating. May have been another video. As of right now, it finna get dark, which means it finna get cold. Y'all can see the sun getting ready to go down. So yeah, I'm finna go ahead and put this stuff up on my truck, put it in my refrigerator where it can stay cold. Then I'm finna go in the house and pour me a little drinky drink, because I'm gonna tell y'all what tomorrow is. I'm finna go ahead and get my duffel bag back there, get my clothes, what I'm gonna wear in the morning. And you know, I'm gonna fix my hair and face and stuff. So when y'all see me in my SUV in the morning, then y'all gonna know what the big announcement is. But yeah, it's some stuff I gotta go do in the house. But I'll probably show y'all what I'm sipping on tonight when I get in the house. But let me go ahead and put this stuff up. Let me go ahead and get my clothes, what I'm gonna wear in the morning, off of my truck. And yeah, I'll see y'all in the next clip. Hold that thought. Hold it. I know that, right?
I'm a boss ass bitch, 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 bitch. I'm a boss ass bitch, 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 bitch. If he catch me.
Okay, y'all, I've been drinking or whatever. I've been drinking like wine ever since I woke up this morning, but whatever. I had no reason to celebrate today.
Your girl closed on a house, y'all. I am a homeowner. I am officially a first-time home buyer. And I have nobody to thank but Jesus, baby. Thank God. Thank Christ, baby. Like, I've been on my own play for the longest. My whole entire life, I've always lived with somebody, bro. Whether it was my parents, my family members, roommates in college. God damn it, I ain't never had nothing to call my own. And, you know, once I went through a breakup or whatever, he went his way, I went mine. I said, girl, you working your ass off. You've been working your ass off for the last 3-4 years now. You've been stacking money. Go ahead and take that money and become a homeowner. Get you something for yourself and your son. And we have a place to call our own. So that is what I decided to do. This took at least about 2 months. I think I've been in the process of doing this since November. These people were very, very speedy about this process, but they were also thorough. They were also very informative. And the questions that I had, they always picked up the phone to answer questions, because it's a lot that go into home ownership, y'all. And real shit, I don't care what kind of house you trying to get, whether it's a home around 200K, 300K. I ain't really in that 400K tax bracket, so I can't give you no advice on it. But if you're looking for a home around 200K or 300K, I strongly recommend at least have you 15 to 20,000 in savings. That's what I recommend. Because you might get you a real estate agent who fire as fuck, like the one I had, who was able to get the seller to pay my closing costs. That way I only had to pay my closing to my mortgage lender and not just the closing overall of the home. But if you can find you a real estate agent like that, baby, you is blessed. That lady negotiated her ass off. I was actually able to meet the seller today. I was able to meet the agent who represented the seller today, because I bought a home that was already built, that's already been on the market. It got a brand new roof on it, floors, paint, everything on the inside is in good condition. It is an older, late 1990s home. I will be getting some footage of it next time I come off of my hometown from the road, because I do got to go back to work today. But I will give y'all some footage of what my house looks like. It is a 3-bed, 2-bath, 2-garage. I absolutely love that I got a garage, y'all, because I've been wanting a garage for the longest, because all I be thinking about is rainy days. And I used to hate when I lived in an apartment, and I used to always have to get my umbrella and walk a long ass ways to where my door was for my apartment complex, and, you know, be in the rain. So it feels really nice to have a house now that actually got a garage. I did get the keys to my house today. So this little button right here, I can automatically let my garage up when I come home, so I can just drive in. I ain't got to worry about that no more. And then I got my keys. So I got all of my paperwork and stuff that's over here, my folders and everything. I'm going to keep that for my records, all of my hard copies. But yeah, it is a blessing, y'all. When I tell y'all I've wanted this for so long, like, you know, I even told my friend, you know, like my little boo thing or whatever. But I was telling him, I was like, even in the past, you know, I thought I had to get in a relationship and get with a man in order to pull this off. And I was with a man, and he didn't even want to be a homeowner. He didn't even care about home ownership. He was just more so stuck on turning up in Atlanta, living in an apartment, and that being that. And I was like, that ain't what I want. You know, I want something I can own and something that's in my control. You ain't got to worry about no tenant going up on you every time the lease up. You ain't got to worry about repair people busting up in your shit every so often for, you know, repairs, and all you get is like a little letter in the email. You know, you take care of your own in Fargo's as your home, and you do what you want to do. And so that's the kind of peace and privacy that I've really wanted for a long time. So I'm happy with the location. I'm happy with where it looks how it looks, you know. I am gonna have to do some DIY type of shit up in the, you know, to, just to get it to my liking, you know what I'm saying, what I really want to be in love with. But like I told y'all, since I spent the money on this motherfucker, all of my goddamn savings on this motherfucker, I mean, don't get it twisted. Now, your girl finna be busting the miles as a truck driver. I'm finna make that money back. Hey, tax time coming too. I'm finna get that savings back, right? Don't even trip, baby. I'm a hustler. Don't never get it twisted, man. I'm gonna get that bank account back up. But you know what I'm saying? It was for a good cause. So I'm not mad at what I spent my savings on. You feel me? But in a fucking way, yeah, it's a little fixer-upper, you know. It gonna need some little stuff done up in there. That's why I told y'all, since I done spent that money on buying this house, that of course ain't gonna leave no money for no wigs. It ain't gonna leave no money for no goddamn clothes. It ain't gonna leave no money for no goddamn makeup. Y'all ain't gonna be seeing them kind of video probably in the next couple of months, baby. Bitch gonna have some bills now, you know what I'm saying, and all the bills gonna be in my motherfucking name. I mean, I done had bills in my name and my name only in the past, but you know, my dude or whatever will give me money towards the bills, and I'm still gonna make some men come up off some money, baby. You gonna talk to me, you gonna come up off some money, period. But any fucking way, I ain't gonna just rely solely on that. I can take care of myself at the end of the day. But yeah, I'ma fucking work, I'ma pay this shit, but at the end of the day, you know, I ain't gonna have a whole lot of money to be splurging like that and dropping hauls and all of that stuff. You know, I got bigger responsibilities now on top of taking care of my son. So with that being said, yeah, y'all probably just gonna get some vlog videos in the future of me fixing up my home, decorating, you know, buying shit for the low, probably getting shit for like $20, $40, shit like that, because I got some really, really great ideas on how I can really bring this home up to par. But like I say, I'm gonna get some before footage where y'all can see what I'm talking about, but that's gonna be later on down the road. But as of right now, shoot, it wine kicking in and I really, really gotta pee. So yeah, I'm about to go to the store and pee, and I'm about to head home because I got to go back to work. I got to let my dispatch know I'm finna come back to work because they only gave me the day off just to get all of this done. You know, I told y'all that yesterday, which in some previous clips of this whole video. So yeah, I got to go do that now. But I did get my lights cut on today. I got my lights set up. My real estate agent, because the seller, I met him for the first time today, and he was basically trying to get everything out of his name and put in my name. But my real estate agent was basically telling me I don't have to get both of them cut on today, the lights and the water. She was like, I can get the lights cut on today, and then when I come back home in 2 weeks, because I come home every 2 weeks, she was like, when I come home 2 weeks from now, then I can get the water cut on, because I guess they trying to keep the heat running until I come back, you know, because it's cold weather and they don't want no pipes to burst or nothing. So I'm like, okay, yeah, that makes sense. So I went on ahead and got that cut on today. I'm not going by the other day. I'm finna go ahead and go home, but I am going by my house when I come back, and hopefully my real estate agent can meet me there and we get some pictures of me holding up the little key. I bought the house and I can upload some pictures and stuff. But the pictures I took today, they will be in this video. But with that being said, I'm happy, y'all. Your girl made it happen. I'm proud of myself. So yeah, I guess I'll talk back to y'all a little bit when I get back home in Athens, because I'm in Conyers right now. That's where the attorney's office is, but my home is in Covington, Georgia. So it's not that far from Atlanta, it's not that far from Athens, Georgia. I think I'm like 40 minutes from Atlanta, 50 minutes from Athens. So it's like I'm right in between, which is absolutely perfect for me, because I love being close to do shit in Atlanta, but I love being close to be home to my parents and be able to pick my son up when I come home as well. Because when I stayed in Gwinnett County, which wasn't far from Atlanta, it was like the same thing. I was like an hour from Athens,
I was like 40-50 minutes from Atlanta. So I was trying to keep that same kind of variation in miles and distance when it came to my home, because like I said, I ain't gonna be OTR truck driving maybe no more than maybe like another year or so. Then I'm gonna come out the road, I'm gonna get me something home daily where I can definitely have my son full time, work out a schedule with me and his father about us having him full time, and you know, just live my life and, you know, keep bossing up, keep making moves and all of that good stuff. You know, this is the beginning, baby. This ain't the end of nothing. So yeah, you know, you just gotta keep a positive mind and keep pushing yourself for better, keep putting goals on yourself, keep manifesting things, and ain't no telling where your ass will be in the next 4-5 years, you know what I'm saying? Because somebody had told me I was gonna make this happen 4-5 years ago when I was cashiering at Walmart and shit, I would have looked at you like you were crazy, like, bitch, what? I'm gonna have 2 cars by the age of 30. I'm gonna goddamn have a house, a cute ass little boy. Shit, a good ass paying job. Shit, you would have told me that 5-6 years ago. I would have been like, what? You for real? That gonna happen to me. You know what I'm saying? But hey, anything possible, man. When you don't let up on where you wanna see yourself in life and what you wanna do and where you wanna be. If you don't let up and you keep your foot on folks' necks and you keep goddamn working your ass off and you don't give up on that goal, that dream, whatever it is you want. Because, you know, we all want something in life. Most of us, we all want something. Sometimes we may not have the funds or the connections for what we want, but we all want something in life. So to be able to accomplish it and make it happen, baby, that's a big pat on the back. But with that being said, y'all, I'll talk to y'all a little bit more when I get home. And then I'm going to roll on out and go to work. And they're probably going to sum up this video. But, yeah, I love y'all and I fuck with y'all, all right? I'm finna get my music going till I get to the house, because I can't play shit while I'm driving, because y'all know YouTube love to copyright music and stuff. So you stealing folks shit when you playing it in the background. So with that being said, I'm just finna go ahead and head on to the house. All right. And that song Blessings by Nicki Minaj, like, bro, that song be making me cry, because I just be thinking about how good God is. Like, bro, I been through it, man. Like, I really been through it. I ain't had nowhere to stay. I've been living with my parents. Bro, they been taking care of my son for me while I've been like out here working. Like, bro, I've been working my ass off. Like, I went through a breakup. I left a place, an area that I really loved, and for so long I didn't think I was gonna find nothing for myself. Like, I ain't never lived on my own. I ain't never had nothing on my own. And for God to have blessed me like this, bro, like, I can't stop fucking crying, because it ain't like crying like I'm sad, but it's like crying that I'm happy, because it just feels so freaking good to know that, you know, if you don't give up, because I swear life be throwing some shit at you, you can really go through some shit in life, like, what, you can get down to your lowest. But when I tell you the power of God is real, man, I'm just thankful. Like, bro, I'm grateful. And I just want to make this video to say, like, whatever you're going through, please don't lose your faith, because you can get through whatever and you can really make it out here on your own. You really can. Like, as a single mom, a single mother, you can really get through some shit, man. It like your kids, they just like motivate you. They motivate you in the strongest way to like really make shit happen. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just... All right, so I done made it back home.
truck, as y'all can see, I parked my SUV back over to my mama's house because I was driving it when I went and met my real estate agent, attorney's office, and the seller when I bought my house. So that's my other car right there, this white one. So I got this car and the SUV. My white car is paid off. My SUV, I got a year and a half left on it, and then I own debt as well. So yeah, them my rides. But yeah, I done hopped back on my truck. I done hit up my dispatch and let them know I done signed my paperwork for my house, because you know, when you're applying for a home, they're gonna verify your employment and all of that. So my job clearly knows that I bought a house. They got me home, the clothes on it. So now I got a load going from East Tuboga, Alabama to Humburg, Indiana. Then I got a load going from Louisville, Kentucky back to Jacksonville, Florida. So I'll probably be back through Atlanta maybe towards the weekend. I'm a little sleepy, to be honest with you, but I at least want to go pick up my trailer, pick up my load, and then however far I drive, based off of that, I may go ahead and get me some sleep. But I done clocked in on my clock, so I got all of that lined up. But this is pretty much the end of my vlog that I purchased the home. I'm a first-time home buyer. The process went fairly well, so now you girl is just finna get ready to go back to work and keep getting this money. You know what I'm saying? I got, what, $800 in savings left? So now it's time to build that savings back up to a couple bands. You feel me? But be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Definitely stay tuned for more videos from me. And I'll see y'all next time, okay? Like I said, I'm gonna keep these vlogs rolling. But I hope y'all enjoying y'all Wednesday, y'all hump day. It's a step closer to the weekend. So yeah, I love y'all and y'all take care. All right, see y'all next time. Bye.